I don't know how you go disc golfing in December, dude. It's way too cold for me. Play around on Christmas every year? That's pretty tight. Yeah, I was definitely on the roof of that house, but whatever. It's just too cold for me. It hurts my hands. A little baby. Norwegian, I'm used to cold hands. True. I mean, I'm Norwegian as well, but then I've been coddled. Yeah, disc golfing Gajiki is going to be interesting, because we've got a lot of people going, I think. Yeah, Bryce has done a good person. He's back up for Titanfall, too. He's also commentating Gunfire Reborn. I'm on the couch for that, but I'm basically on the couch just to be a hype man. Chuck and Briar are gonna explain. They're gonna do most of the commentary. Yeah, no, Gunfire is sick. Like, literally, the funny part is the only reason Chuck is running it is because, I needed a fill for an aimbot show one time, and he was like, oh, I've been playing Reborn. I could come on and, like, do a showcase, and I was like, okay, sure. And, he just whipped it out and started running it. And then a week later, DM'd me and was like, hey, I got a world record for this category. I was like, oh, you should submit that to GDQ then. Tell you what game I am. I need to do my research because I don't think it's ever been at a GDQ, but I want to see a dot hack game at a GDQ. But to get that, people need to submit it. So this may be a case of I learned the game myself. What I did for Quake. Thank you. Shenmue 1. Someone, I think it's Maxi, keeps submitting one of the Shenmues. But the problem is the game is 6 fucking hours long. So. The 32-minute section where you can literally walk away. Like, skip 32 minutes. Okay, so, like, that's gonna have a real hard time getting in, but what they could do is just do, like, a home pour situation where you just submit another thing alongside Shenmue and be like, for the 32-minute section, we're going to do this other game. Yeah, 6 hits. Okay, so I knew that because it's bonker off the top and then bonker in the head. Wait, no, please, I need to go up. Oh, I got that! Let's go! Moose is 3 hits. You have to explode an enemy on him 3 times. Another Shenmue game with the sub 32 run. Dude, I don't think you understand. Shenmue games are like 5 hours minimum. Like, I think they have... the entire one's for you, babe. I think they have, like, a cutscene skip. Anyway, May, do you see why I've been saying the Celeste Enjoyer should run this game? Because it's tight as fuck. Like, Moose is the only just absolute dog shit part of this run. Everything else. Everything else is good. You an undress? Well, you don't enjoy good games. Gotta say. Pokemon? Who the fuck likes Pokemon? Although, please, sir. Please, sir, stop standing in the middle. I did hear that Cinda wants to learn a Pokemon game at GDQ. So, should help her out with that. Let's go. There you go, babe. You can do true co-op. Only if that involves the second person, like, not really knowing how to play the game. Because I'm okay with that. Second person does fuck all? Hell yeah. Literally only menu? Alright, we could do that. I mean, Cinda does have a world record. Like, we have, We have a world record in Outriders three-person co-op. And y'all can steal the world record. Not steal. Respectfully take. I disagree. Alright, whatever. Said died early. No, I'm the second person doing fuck all. She's the actual runner. I have not played. Let's go. Moose just absolute worst boss in the entire run. I guess there had to be one. Like, right? Like, the game couldn't have been perfect. So the problem with, I've been thinking about that for, like, you know, could we, like, skip the moose? The problem is, he has the speed and, like, those are huge. I don't think skipping, because, like, this boss fight would be, like, 2 minutes or so. I don't think the 2 minutes that you would save is, like, skipping the boots would save 2 minutes. It's true. I mean, not having to fight him would be, like, so nice. Someone needs to come up with, not me, a consistent AI manip for him, just to make him do the same thing every single time. And we do the same moves, and then he dies, and it's easy. Or if there are a way to get the boots without having to fight him. If we could do that, sure. I don't give a fuck. I'll skip that moose. Any change you want to see in the world? No. I'm gonna let someone smarter than me do that. I'm a grinder. I sit down and I grind out runs. I learn the shit and then I do it. Purple bounty. Yeah. I already have one uncompletable bounty. I don't really want to put up another. I disagree with that. But, okay. There we go. That's my bounty. I have a... And realistically, I could increase this to, like, whatever dollar amount I want, because nobody's ever fucking finding it. Hang on, gotta do this part. I have a bounty out for skipping Control Core Angel in Borderlands 2. Because it's just the worst part of Borderlands 2. It's like a 4-minute auto scroller. Easy to delete from the game files. Yeah. Now we've tried quite a lot to actually skip it. Shock and I spent Probably 3 solid hours just testing shit one day. The other problem with skipping a lot of things in this game is that, like, it's very vertical. So, you know, being able to skip anything is pretty difficult. Like, you actually... Fafnir, I think, is unskippable. Unless you find out a way to, like... get underneath his platform and get the ground pound, because the ground pound is what kills the final boss. Like, you can't kill... You might be able to axe him, but... I didn't try. But the only way that I know of is to ground pound the final boss. You definitely can't skip the axe, because the axe is the only actual way that you can hurt the final guy. You could, like, maybe skip, like, Holder. For the water zoom, but, like, even then, I think that one would be a stretch. Because you need the water zoom. I guess you could swim. But I think this is definitely one of those things where, like, the time save from skipping it is, like, not worth it. Well, I guess you do need some of the water bounce. Like, unless you can avoid falling off the bridge. Because there's an invisible wall at the end of it. Like, I actually did try that. If you can, when you're jumping across the bridge, you can make it to the end before the thing actually breaks. But there's an invisible wall there, and it stops you. So I think this, like, I can't realistically see much else getting skipped out of this run. I'm gonna be so mad if he does something that hurts me. Okay, I didn't mean to go that way, but, like, sure, that works. Yeah, I didn't think about the blue aura thing. But I mean, I don't know. I think, just given the abilities Like, so Tesseract 1 actually has a really interesting way you fight the final boss in that you don't. He's only active in a very specific, like, trigger zone. And so, to skip the final boss, you just blink past the trigger that activates him. So the run is super fucking short. Oh my god. Sub 3 out to here if I hadn't just bongoed it like an absolute maroon. To the door. Opens.
Let's go.
The fun part. I'm gonna get this ice thing in one run eventually, just like so fucking clean. I didn't want to ground pound there.
There we go.
So if I wait just a little bit, I can get on that way fucking earlier. I didn't know you could do that without ledge grabbing there, that's kinda tight. I can't believe he gives me that grab. I could try slide activating that, but it, I don't know. The one thing I think this game really needs is a way to speed up climbs. I can just straight up mulch dudes with that. That's interesting. Jump the right way because I wasn't facing outward. All right. cutscene. A little bit of a break. I wonder if there's, like, exit to menu shenanigans I can do to skip this. I have a feeling that that might be possible. So that thing goes, like, loses collision, like, immediately. I lose a little bit of time here. I think if I do good enough here, this is sub 40. And so, like, I think sub 35 is my next goal. I don't know that sub 35 is possible, but I think it's a goal. Just need to break one for that first one. Acquired. There we go. Oop. All right. Made it through. I'll wait for that cycle. That's fine. Oh, keep moving. Thank you. Only had to break two. Any attempt to skipping the picture? So, it doesn't unlock anything, but, like, it's the... I need to get by it to, like, get to the rest of the level. Is the thing. Axe jump? True. I could axe jump over that. That's pretty good. Sub 40 by a lot. Yeah, I'll take that. God damn, this run is tight. I think I had a second try moose as well, too, so I can save another like 50 seconds if I get that correct.